Hello friends, welcome to Stock Trading Tutor channel. I used to make tutorial video based on stock market. Guys, if you have not yet joined my free technical classes, then you can give a miss call on 9606046814. Or guys, you can, for opening the Demat account also, you can give the miss call in the same number. Guys, if you are having any doubt regarding the opening a Demat account, or if you are having any doubt in this series of future trading, you can give a comment in the comment box. So in this chapter, we are going to discuss about the second part of the leverage and payoff. Here we will discuss about the futures payoff. Already in the previous chapters, we have discussed about the leverages. So imagine this, when I bought a TCS futures, the expectations was that TCS stock price would go higher, and therefore I would financially benefit from the future transactions. But what it if instead of going up, a stock TCS stock price went down, so I would obviously make a loss and think about it, and after initiating a future trade at every price point, I would either stand to make a profit or a loss. The payoff structures of a futures transaction simply highlights the extent or to which I either make a profit or a loss at a various possible price points. To understand the payoff structure better, let us build one for the TCS trade. Remember, it is a long trade initiated at rupees of 2362 on the 16th of the December. After initiating the trade by 23rd December, the price of TCS can go anywhere. So like I mentioned, at every price point, I will either make a profit or a loss. Hence, while building a payoff structure, I will assume various possible prices, point situations that can pan out by 23rd of December. And I will analyze the profit and loss situation at each of these possibilities. And in fact, the table below does the same. You can see here possible price on 23rd December and buyer profit and loss price on 23rd December when the buy price is. So you can see here 2160 means here 202 is the buy price, buyer's profit or loss. So here you can see possible prices here gone up to 2520, and buyer can get a 158 of profit. Here red color, you can see that is a loss it's indicating. So this is the way you need to read this table, considering you are a buyer at a rupees of 2362, and what would be the profit and loss on the 23rd December, assuming the TCS is trading in a rupees of 2160, as the table suggests, you would make a loss of rupees 202 per share. So here you can just subtract from the 2362 minus 2160. Likewise, what would be your profit and loss if the TCS is trading at rupees 2600? Well, as the table suggests, you would make a profit of rupees 238 per share, and you can just calculate by subtracting 2600 minus 2362, so on and so forth. So in fact, if you recollect from the previous chapter, we stated that if the buyer is making of rupees X as a profit, then the seller is suffering a loss to the extent of rupees X. So assuming 23rd December TCS is trading at rupees 2600, the buyer makes a profit of rupees 238 per share, and seller would be making a loss of rupees 238 per share. So provided that the sellers has shorted and shares are the rupees of 2362. Another way to look at this is that money is being transferred from the seller's pocket to the buyer's pocket. It's a just transfer to money and not a certain money. So here there is a difference between the transfer of a money and creation of a money. So money is generated when value is created. For example, you have bought a TCS shares from a long term perspective. TCS as a business does well, profit and margin improve the obviously, and so as a shareholder will benefit with the virtue of appreciation in a share price. So this is money creation or wealth generation. If you contrast with futures, money is not being created, but rather moving from one pocket to another. Precisely for the reason futures, rather the financial derivatives is generally is called the zero sum game. So further, let us know, plot a graph of a possible price on 23rd December versus the buyer profit and loss. This is also called as payoff structure. So here you can see in the screen, the buyer profit and loss price on 23rd December. Buyer price here you can see it started from 2160 and it was a loss of rupees 225. So near about it reaches to 225 as a positive and a profit when the price reaches to the 200,600. So it's a you can see the inclining line here shows the buyer profit or loss. So guys, from the previous chapter and this chapter including, I am given key takeaways from these chapters. Both the chapters, you can just note out the points. The leverage plays a key role in the future trading. Margin allows us to deposit a small amount of money and take exposure to a large value transactions. Margin charge is usually 8% of a contract value, and spot market transactions are not leveraged, and we can transact so that to the extent of the capital that we have. So by virtue of a leverage, a small change in the underlying results in a massive impact on the profit and loss. The profit made by the buyer is equivalent to the loss made by the seller and vice versa. The higher the leverage, the higher is risk, and therefore the higher is the chance of making money. So future instrument simply allows one to transfer money from one pocket to another. Hence it is called as zero sum game. The payoff structure of the futures instrument is linear. So we already checked in the chart and in the graph of the payoff structures, it was like a linear. So thank you for watching this video, and if you are having any queries regarding the leverage and payoff, you can give a comment in the comment box. And guys, if you have not yet joined my free technical classes, then you can give a missed call on 9606046816. And if you're new to this video, please subscribe, like and share.